Hi everyone, today in Sangi's Cookery we are going to see how to make the white pumpkin kootu. This is going to be a blend of white pumpkin and chana dal, so it's going to have an excellent flavor. While the mix of chana dal and the white pumpkin with the coconut green chili mixture, it's going to be really fantastic dish, and this is especially useful the days when we should not have onion and garlic along with chapatis. This is the best combination. Let's see how to make.
I've taken white pumpkin. I've cut it into pieces. This is about 300 grams approximately. I've taken 1/4 cup of chana dal. I've soaked in water. I've taken a handful of cut coconut, or you can, if it's a small coconut, you can take 1/2 cup grated. Jeera, 1 teaspoon. Some curry leaves, 1 tablespoon of raw rice I've soaked in water, 2 green chilies, and 1 red chili which is split into pieces, along with urad dal 1 teaspoon and mustard 1 teaspoon, salt as per taste, and little bit turmeric powder while cooking. First, I'm going to pressure cook this chana dal for 3 whistles in cooker. Let's start the procedure by adding the pumpkin. I've chopped it in this size, you see, small cubes. Can add in some water. Basically, it has to be fully immersed in water because it has to cook nicely. I'm adding some turmeric salt prepared for cooking. So, the white pumpkin is getting cooked. I'm going to keep it in medium flame. I'm also going to close it and cook. Grind the following ingredients in the mixie jar. About 1 teaspoon of jeera and a handful of coconut pieces. 2 green chilies. 1 tablespoon of the soaked raw rice. And a few curry leaves while grinding. You can grind this into a smooth paste by adding some water. Now you can see the pumpkin is almost 3/4 done. At this stage, I'm adding in the cooked chana dal, which I've kept in the cooker by adding a little bit of turmeric. I've kept it for 3 whistles. It is cooked well. It should not be a fine paste. You should be able to see the chana dal like this. If you press it, you should be able to break it. So that is the consistency. So you can add it in the pumpkin. Now you can add a little more salt required for the chana dal, because while cooking in the cooker, I have not added salt and allowing it to cook for a few more minutes. Keep the flame in medium. Now it's been cooking for almost about 10 to 15 minutes in medium flame. You can see the pumpkin has cooked well and the water is also almost absorbed. There's very less water, that's fine, because this is kootu and not poriyal, so a little bit of water should be okay, because by the time we start eating it will be incorrect. So at this stage I'll just add the ground paste of coconut, jeera, green chili and the soaked rice. Mix it up nicely. Now the kootu has come to a correct consistency. At this stage you can switch off the gas and we just have to do the tempering. I've added around 2 teaspoons of coconut oil. I'll be adding 1 teaspoon of mustard. Once it begins to splutter, I'm adding the urad dal and the red chili as well. Once the urad dal has turned slightly brown in color, we'll add the curry leaf. Then we'll transfer the seasoning in our kootu.
So the white pumpkin kootu, or the vella pushnika kootu, which the Tamilians call it as, or the Kerala Brahmins call it as elavan kootu, is ready. It's got excellent flavor, especially the tempering of coconut oil gives you a very good flavor. This is a secret tip which I'm sharing. So please do season with the coconut oil. This particular kootu can be had along with sambar rice or with rasam, or it can be had along with plain rice. You can just mix it with plain hot steaming rice and have it just like that. It's an excellent combination along with rotis. I'm remembering the days when I used to be small and we all cousins used to make in Bombay chapatis, and this kootu used to be a preparation which has been there every day. So I'm definitely remembering all my Bombay cousins while I'm preparing this. I hope you'll try this dish, and if you like this, please kindly share and subscribe to my channel. Thank you.